There have been criticisms that the Red Cross was a bit slow off the mark with Staten Island. Do you accept that criticism? And what reassurance can you give the people there now that they're getting your full attention?
Well, first, let me say that my heart goes out to the people on Staten Island and the people up and down the Eastern Seaboard. This has been a devastating, devastating disaster. We have about 14,000 people in shelters. We're serving 250,000 meals already, and it's a massive operation. And I completely understand why the people in Staten Island are frustrated. We're frustrated, too. We had sent out emergency response vehicles before this cry for help came, but I completely understand why folks are frustrated, and we were able to break through yesterday. The roads are snarled. There are fuel issues. We're sending volunteers from all over the country, almost all 50 states. We've got two-thirds of our emergency response vehicles going from the West Coast all the way across the country to the Eastern Seaboard, and it took a while for us to break through and get there. And I'm just grateful that my teams made it. They are handing out meals. They're driving up and down the streets, alerting people that we're here. And I spent the day in Staten Island with the borough president, and I completely understand his frustration.
If people are watching and wish to contribute to the Red Cross for this, what's the best way of doing that?
They can visit our website, redcross.org, or they can call 1-800-RED-CROSS. And as always, the American public has just been so generous, and we are grateful for every single donation.
Well, you guys do a terrific job, and I'm a huge admirer of the Red Cross, and I can only imagine it's been utter chaos all over the area for the last 4 days. So please continue to do the excellent work that you do, and I'm just very glad, like you are, that the Staten Island people are getting the help they obviously so urgently need. Thank you very much.